Here we're going to look at graphing piecewise defined functions. Now the given problem that we're going to work with is as follows. It shows us that f of x equals negative x plus 2 if x is less than or equal to 1, or x squared if x is greater than 1. So you notice that this graph is going to be graphed in two pieces depending on what the value of x is. Now if you look, we have one equation, and it's if x is less than or equal to 1, and then the other equation is if x is greater than 1. So this all centers around 1. So what I like to do is I like to draw a vertical line, just a dotted vertical line where x equals 1. Now this is not necessary or required, but I find that it helps me know where my stopping point is. This shows me that to the right of this dotted line will be the graph x squared. To the left of this dotted line will be the graph of y equals negative x plus 2. Neither graph should cross over that dotted line, so it lets you know that is where you stop. Well, let's go ahead and graph this. Let's start with the first equation. The first equation is f of x equals negative x plus 2. Now we can graph these using or creating an xy table. Now if you notice, there is a condition on this equation. It says that x has to be less than or equal to 1. So I'm going to start with 1. And since this is a linear equation, I'm just going to choose two other points. But I do have to keep it less than or equal to 1. So that means 0 and negative 1. Now to get the y value, we just substitute these points back into the equation. So with the first one, when x is 1, we would have negative 1 because it's negative x plus 2. And that gives me 1, so that would be the y value. For the next one, negative 0 plus 2, but negative 0 would just be 0, and that gives me 2. Be careful with the next one. The equation says the negative of x. Well, in this case, x is negative 1 now. Well, two negatives make a positive, so that actually turns into 1. And then plus 2 is 3. So now I have the other values for my table, and we're ready to graph. So my first point is going to be at 1, 1. And I'm actually going to use a closed circle because it does say I can include 1. In the beginning it said x less than or equal to. We'll show you what happens when we don't include 1. The next point was 0, 2, followed by negative 1, 3. Now using a straight edge, if you have one, you want to connect those three points and draw your line. So as you can see here, this would be the first part of the piecewise defined function. That's to the left of our dotted line. But now we have to graph something to the right. And if you look back at the original equation, I have another equation to graph, and that's f of x equals fx squared. Now again, we can create a table for this, but I have to be careful with my values. This says x greater than 1, so I am going to start with 1, and I'll show you what we do with that, and then it says greater than 1. So I need to go to 2, and maybe I'll do 3 as well. Now we just plug it in. So the first one would be 1 squared, and that is 1. And I have my y value. Then we do 2 squared, which is 4, and 3 squared, which is 9. Then we plot our points. So the first one is 1, 1. Now, if there was not a point already at the point 1, 1, then in that case, we'd have to use an open circle because it does say we cannot include 1. It says strictly greater than 1. So I would use an open circle. But because we already have a point on there, it's just going to overlap the point that's there. The next point is 2, 4. So then we go up from 2 to 4. And then 3, 9 goes up further. But again, that goes out of my chart. So we know it's up there somewhere. But remember, this is the equation y equals x squared. That has more of that U-shaped graph, but we're only graphing part of it. So just don't forget, this does have a curve to it. So it's not a straight line. Be careful. The only straight lines we would have is if the equation is in the form mx plus b. But as soon as we have x squared, x cubed, and so forth, we're going to start adding more bends and curves to our equation. So now we have this graph, and you are done. This is your piecewise defined function. You have it in the two pieces that we were given. To the left of x equals 1, we have negative x plus 2. And to the right, we have the point, or the graph, y equals x squared. And again, remember, notice that they did not cross over that line. So that's your stopping point. And now you've graphed a piecewise defined function.